Okay, good morning students. So today we will going to discuss a topic that comes under cloud computing, and the topic name is service level agreement, or shortly we can able to say SLA. Service level agreement. So service level agreement means it is nothing but an agreement which is going to create between consumers and service providers. So service level agreement is nothing but it is an agreement which is going to create between a consumer and service provider. So as we all know, cloud computing is having a lot of advantages. We can able to do, we can able to store any kind of information, or we can able to use the cloud environment as a database. We can able to get the help of some servers. We can able to get the network facilities. We can able to get some application level facilities. If we need to build some applications, we can take the help of cloud environment to build the application also. So for all these kind of advantages, we can able to use the cloud environment or the cloud facilities. So who will provide these cloud facilities? Obviously we need some service providers. So we are having in the real world, we are having a lot of service providers which are available, and they are always available to provide the services to the users. So as an example, one a very good example is Amazon. Amazon is providing a lot of services, cloud based facilities to the consumers. Google is providing a lot of services, and under Amazon AWS is available, Amazon Web Services are available, and Amazon Simple Storage Services, Amazon SSS or S3 is available, and in the similar manner Windows Azure. So a lot of service providers are available. So I can write some of the examples here so that you can able to understand easily. So I think, hope everyone is having enough experience to use the cloud environment, because nowadays all are using the Google facilities, all are having experience while using the Google facilities like Google Sheets, Google Docs, that all comes under the cloud level applications, because they are providing a software or they are providing an application to the consumers, and we can freely use these kind of cloud facilities. But some kind of facilities are free for available and some we need to pay. So always the cloud environment, cloud facilities, they are providing paper use manner, and most of the facilities are under paper use manner, because paper use is nothing but after the usage we need to pay, I mean the consumers need to pay, and some are freely available also. Freely we can able to use the cloud facilities. So moving to the topic, service level agreement. I told you service level agreement is nothing but an agreement which is going to create between a consumer and a service provider. So why they are creating the service level agreement? It is nothing but while we are going to start a usage of any kind of services which comes under the service provider, the consumer obviously need to create an agreement, because whenever in the middle of the service or whenever in the middle of the application creation, any kind of troubles they can face, or in the starting itself, the provider can able to tell the consumer like these all the things we are providing, and these are all the strategies, and these are the terms and conditions we are going to put you under. So all these terms and conditions comes under service level agreement. So the terms and conditions, they make it as a contract, or they make it as an agreement, and they are going to sign, I mean the consumer and service provider will sign under that agreement. Okay, so simply I can tell you service level agreement is nothing but it is an agreement based on the services, and this agreement is going to create between a consumer and the service provider. Okay, so today I am going to explain you the life cycle of SLA and SLA management under cloud environment. Okay, so these two topics you need to study under service level agreement, life cycle of SLA and the SLA management under cloud environment. So first let me explain you about the life cycle of SLA, life cycle of service level agreement. Life cycle of SLA. and this life cycle of SLA, it is having some phases. I mean, five phases they are having. So the first phase is nothing but contract definition. Each phases is having its own functionalities, its own process. Each of this phases are having its own process. So let me explain you each of the phases individually. So first of all, I will just tell you what are all the five phases. So life cycle of service level agreement is having five phases. The first phase is contract definition. Second one is publication and discovery. Publication and discovery. And third one is nothing but negotiation. Fourth one is operationalization. And the last one is decommissioning. Okay, so these are the five phases of life cycle, the five phases of SLA life cycle. So let me explain you each one. The first one is contract definition. Okay, so here we are explaining this particular life cycle that will be based on a consumer and a service provider. Okay, so based on consumer and service provider, I am just explaining you this particular life cycle, and these two part, this part and this part will comes under the service provider. Okay, so first of all, contract definition is nothing but defining a service. So as a service provider, if I am going to provide a service, I mean a cloud service to the outside users, what the thing I need to do first? First of all, I need to define the contract. I mean, I need to define the services, what I am going to provide, what service or which services or how much I am going to provide. So that particular detail I need to define, and this definition comes under the contract definition. For example, if I am going to provide a storage space for the outside users, I need to define what is the service. I mean, as a database service, I am going to provide the service, and how much space I am going to allot for a particular user, or how much I am going to ask, I am going to price for that particular usage. So this particular thing will come under the contract definition. So contract definition is nothing but defining the service or defining that particular contract. Okay, so this is based on service provider. Okay, so just remember, contract definition is nothing related to a consumer, it is totally based on a service provider. So hope you understand contract definition, it is nothing but a service definition document. And the second one is publication and discovery. So first of all, publication, how I can able to reach the users. So I am going to provide a service to the users, how the users, I mean how the outside world can able to know I am going to provide the service, I need to publish. So for that, this publication step will come. Publication in the sense, you can able to publish in any kind of social media, you can advertise, you can put the news under a newspaper. So at any kind of way or through any way, you can able to publish your service. So publication is nothing but the service provider need to publish or need to advertise that particular service to the outside world people, so that the outside users can able to understand this service is available, so they can able to reach you. So publication is nothing but publishing or advertising your service under a social media website or any kind of newspapers or any kind of medias, you can use this publication. And discovery is nothing but it comes under consumer side. Okay, so this publication comes under service provider side, and discovery comes under consumer side. So the discovery, what the consumer will do always, if I am a user, I need to just get, for example, simple say Google Sheets, I need to use one Excel and I don't have any kind of Excel software in my system or in my laptop. So what I will do, I will search in Google. In Google means all the online Excels are available, I can able to find out. So discovery is based on the consumer. Consumer need to search based on their requirements regarding the service, they need to search and they can able to find a list of services. I mean, based on their requirements, they will get a lot of services. I mean, some five services they will get, and they can able to choose which one they want, which is the best option for the consumer. Okay, so the discovery comes under consumer. Consumer, what the consumer need to do? Consumer need to search based on the consumer's requirements, and they will get a list of services which is available under the cloud environment or which is available under cloud facilities, and they can able to opt a better option. Okay, so this is the second step. And the third step is negotiation. So after choosing a particular service, they need to contact, I mean the consumer need to contact the service provider. So I am just choosing a service which comes under AWS, I mean Amazon Web Services. What the consumer need to do? Consumer need to contact the service provider. So the service provider is nothing but the Amazon. So what the consumer need to do? They need to contact the Amazon and they need to negotiate. Negotiate based on what? Negotiate based on the consumer's requirements. I mean the consumer need some kind of facilities and they need to contact this particular service provider for their requirements, and they will have some price details. I mean the consumer need to pay some $15 per minute or per hour, but the Amazon what they kept is $20 per hour. So they need to negotiate based on the price, based on the facilities, based on the resources. So all these negotiation will be happened between a consumer and a service provider. And at what time this particular step will come? After discovering or after choosing the exact services by the consumer need to negotiate with the service provider based on the facility. And after negotiation, this operationalization step will come. So operationalization is nothing but after negotiation, the consumer and service provider can able to put the signature under service level agreement. So after fixing all the things, after fixing the service, they can able to start operating that service. Operating that service means service provider will provide the service to the consumer. The user can able to use that service based on the terms and conditions. So always you need to remember, always based on the service level agreement, they will start doing the work. Okay. So operationalization is nothing but based on the agreement. After the negotiation, they will create one agreement based on the services. So based on that agreement, they need to start doing the operation. They can able to use the services. And this operationalization will be done under consumers. Consumers are nothing but users, the normal users. And at that particular time, while using or while operating the service, if any kind of problems they will face, they can able to contact the service provider, or service provider will always monitor the service. So if I am providing an application to the outside users, always I am the owner of the application. So always I will be in touch with the user. I will always check or I will always monitor whether this particular application is running properly or this particular application is running smoothly. They are not facing any trouble. So I will always contact with the consumers and I will always just contact with the consumers regarding this particular service. So while operating, service provider will always monitor the services. Service provider will always monitor the services and they will check whether any problems the consumers are facing while doing the services. So all these things will come under the fourth phase, I mean the operationalization. And finally, the fifth one is decommissioning. So decommissioning is nothing but after the usage, or if I am a user and I completed the entire services and I don't want that service anymore, what I can do is I can able to decommission that service. Decommissioning is nothing but terminating the service. Terminating is nothing but just telling back the service provider that I don't want the service anymore. So like this, I can able to terminate the service. And after decommissioning, the consumer will not be a part of that service and they will just cancel the agreement. Okay. So these are the main five phases that comes under the life cycle of SLA. Once again, I can explain you. First phase is nothing but contract definition. Contract definition is nothing but the service provider need to create or need to explain regarding the contract and need to tell about the services based on the providings. And the second one is service provider need to publish their services in any kind of social media or any kind of newspaper. They need to advertise and they need to reach the users. As a user, user need to discover their exact services based on their requirements. And in the negotiation part, the consumer and service provider will sit together and negotiate based on the services regarding price, regarding facilities, regarding resources, whatever they are providing, and they can able to negotiate and fix the agreement. And operationalization is nothing but the consumers can start doing the operation of the services and they can use the services in a full-fledged manner. And finally, after usage, the user can able to terminate. I mean, the user can able to stop doing the services and report the service provider to cancel the service. Okay. So these are the five phases of life cycle of SLA.